Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Gems of Knowledge. Today we are here in the next part of the video, that is exercise 4.3 of the chapter Understanding Quadrilaterals from class 8. So before starting this exercise, we should know the few things about the quadrilateral. We should know what are the types of quadrilateral. So before starting this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also click the bell button to get the notification as soon as I post my new videos. Okay, so here you can see the types of quadrilateral or the kinds of quadrilateral are given as follows. So in this, the type of quadrilateral, the first one is trapezium. So what is trapezium? It is a quadrilateral with a pair of parallel sides. Okay, so here you can see in the figure what is trapezium. It is a quadrilateral which has a pair of parallel sides. It should have two parallel sides, okay? Pair of parallel sides, okay? Here you can see A, B, C, D is a trapezium because this AB is equals to DC. Similarly here, A, B, C, D is also a trapezium because AD is equal to BC, okay? It means at least one pair of parallel side must be there in this trapezium, okay? So next comes the kite. So what is a kite? It is a special type of quadrilateral. So inside this, this kite is nothing but a special type of quadrilateral. The side which has same markings are equal. So here the side which is having the same markings are equal. So you can see here one, this AD and AB is having the same marking, single marking. Whereas this DC and CB is having the double markings. Okay. So it means here the adjacent sides are equal. One side, one adjacent, one pair of adjacent sides are equal. Okay. So this DC is equals to BC. Whereas this AD is equals to AB. Okay. So this two sides are equal and this two sides are equal. So similarly here this two sides are equal and this two sides are equal. Whereas here AD is equals to DC and AB is equals to BC. Okay. So this is about the kite. Okay. Next we should learn what are the properties of kite. So the properties here, they have given the three properties of kite. So first one, it has four sides. So normally in the examples you can see all the kites are having how many sides? Four sides. Okay. Second, it is a quadrilateral. Obviously when we are here we are studying about the kinds of quadrilateral. So it is important for a kite to be a quadrilateral first. Okay. Then there are two consecutive pair of sides of equal length. Okay. Consecutive means the very next side of this kite is of equal length. So you can see CD is equal to this BC, means the very next of this side is having the equal length. Okay. So next comes parallelogram. So you can see what is parallelogram here. It is a quadrilateral whose opposite sides are parallel. So here the opposite sides are nothing but they are parallel to one another. Here AD is equal to BC and CD is equals to AB. So this two sides are parallel to each other and this two sides are parallel to each other. It means opposite sides must be parallel to each other. Okay. Now next you have to study the properties of parallelogram. So here they have given four properties of parallelogram. First property is nothing but the definition itself, that is opposite sides are equal. Parallel in the sense we can say they both are equal to. Okay. So opposite sides are equal. Similarly we can say opposite angles are also equal. Okay. If the opposite sides are equal, then obviously the opposite angles will be equal. Opposite angles, not the same angles, opposite angles must be equal. Then adjacent angles are supplementary. Okay. So what do you mean by adjacent angle? So this C is the adjacent angle for this D. Otherwise it is the adjacent angle for this B. So this B plus C, when we add both this angle B plus angle C, it is going to be supplementary. Supplementary is nothing but it will become 180 degree. Okay. supplementary is nothing but it will become 180 degree. If we add this as well as this angle, if we are going to add this both the angles, that is angle B plus angle C, it is going to become nothing but 180 degree. Okay, either if we add angle C and D, okay, except this angle, if we add angle C and angle D, then also the total of these angles is going to become 180 degree only. So it is said that adjacent angles are supplementary. Okay, then the last fourth point what they have given is diagonals bisect each other. Okay, so here you can see this one. Okay, this is one diagonal, and similarly this will become the another diagonal. So this both the diagonals are bisecting each other. Okay, bisecting means they will meet at some point. Okay, so these two diagonals will meet at some point. So they have told diagonals bisect each other, they cross over each other. Okay, so depending on all this, you have to solve this exercise, that is exercise 4.3 from your textbook, that is understanding quadrilaterals. Okay, so let's start with the exercise. So the first question given here is given parallelogram ABCD. Okay, so here one more parallelogram is given, ABCD. Complete each statement. So here four statements are given. We have to complete this four statement along with a definition or property used. Either we have to use a definition here or a property used, and we have to complete this statements. Okay, you can see the first question here, AD is equals to, so here they have given AD. Okay, so what this AD is equals to, directly we will write the answer. AD is equals to, here we will write first one, AD is equal to nothing but this AD is equals to BC. Since why this AD is equals to BC? Because opposite sides are equal. So the first property what we have studied about the parallelogram was nothing but the opposite sides are equal. So here opposite sides will be equal. Okay. Next you can see DCB. So DCB, this angle is given. Okay. This angle is equals to this angle. We can write second one, angle DCB is equals to angle DAB. Since the second property what we have studied, that is opposite angles are equal. These are nothing but the properties of parallelogram what we have studied just now. So the third one, OC is given. Okay, so the third case here, OC, what is the OC here? This OC is equals to, we can write this OC is equals to OA. Okay, this OC is equals to OA because we have studied one property here, that is the diagonal bisect each other. Okay, these are the two diagonals, they are bisecting each other. Bisecting in the sense they are cutting each other at a point. Okay, this point, this is a point at which they are cutting each other. So after cutting each other, all these diagonals will be divided into equal parts. Okay, so we can write this OC is equals to this OA. Okay, since diagonal bisects each other. After bisecting, both the diagonals will cut into equally half parts. So if this is 2 cm, this also will be of 2 cm only. They will be equally divided into half parts. Okay, next fourth one, M into angle DAB. So just see angle DAB, this angle they have given. Okay, this angle they have given, angle DAB plus angle CDA. Okay, this angle. When we add this both the angles, what we are going to get? Fourth one. So here we are getting M of DAB, angle DAB plus M of angle CDA. Okay. So this angle plus this angle. which is equal to, we are getting 180 degree. Why we are getting 180 degree? Because of the property, adjacent angles are supplementary. Okay, so adjacent angles are nothing but here supplementary. So I told you the supplementary means both the angles, when we add both the angles, we are getting the sum of 180 degree. Okay, when we add this both the angles, we are going to get 180 degree. Okay, so this is the solution for the first one question. Okay, next, considering the second one question, you can see here, consider the following parallelograms. So here few parallelograms are given, find the values of the unknown. So here they have given, inside this they have given some unknowns, that is x, y and z. We have to find the values of those unknowns. Okay, now just see here, they have given us angle B is equals to 100 degree. Okay, if angle B is equals to 100 degree, the opposite angle, so if the angle B is nothing but 100 degree, then according to the property of parallelogram, we have studied, the opposite angle will be equal. So directly we can write angle Y is equals to 100 degree. Since we can write opposite angles are equal. Okay, since opposite angles are equal, we can write angle Y is equals to nothing but, this angle is nothing but 100 degree. Okay, then we know one more property, that is X plus angle C plus angle B. I told you this angle and this angle, adjacent angles will be equal to 180 degree. Okay, supplementary angles. Okay, adjacent angles will be supplementary. So we don't know what is angle C. So we will take this as X plus angle B is nothing but 100, which is equals to 180 degree. So we will get X is equals to 180 degree minus 100. When we bring this 100 to this side, it will become 180 minus 100. So we will get the answer as 80 degree. So this X is nothing but, it is 80 degree. Okay, X we got as 80 degree, Y we got as 100 degree, X we got as, we'll write here, X is equals to 80 degree. Okay, then if X is equals to 80 degree, then the opposite angle, that is Z, will be equals to, angle Z will be equals to 80 degree. Since opposite angles are equal. Okay, then moving to the next question here, you can see one more question here. One angle is given as 50 and X, Y and one external angle, the angle outside this parallelogram is given as Z. So we have to find the value of X, Y and Z. So first we will take this part, 50 plus X, angle 50 degree plus X is equals to how much? 180 degree, since these both are the adjacent angles. Okay, side by side, when two angles are side by side, they are called as adjacent angles. So these two angles are, when we add this, we are going to get the answer as 180 degree. Okay, so from this we can write X is equals to, 180 will be as it is, we will take this 50 to this side, it will become minus 50. So we will get X is equals to, 180 minus 50 is nothing but 130 degree. So here we got X is equals to 130 degree. If this is 130 degree, obviously the opposite angle will be how much? Y is equals to, angle Y is equals to 130 degree. Similarly, if this is the opposite angle, okay, here we will write opposite angle for X. Okay, then we can see here angle X is equals to angle Z, even X is equals to angle Z, angle X is equals to angle Z, because these are nothing but the corresponding angle. Okay, So I think you have studied this previously in your 7th standard or primary level classes. What are corresponding angles? What are vertically opposite angles? What are alternate angles? So when the two angles are similar, just see here, this way and this way, okay, two angles. When the two lines, if the two lines are given and one line is crossing both the lines, the angles, two angles which are formed here. Since, okay, just see here, I will show you here what is corresponding angle. Suppose if the two lines are parallel and a transversal line is cutting both the angles, then the angle formed here and here will be equal. Okay, so this is in the similar case. This is similar to the parallel line and one more line. This is a transversal which is cutting it. And these are the two angles which is nothing but equal. Okay, so this is nothing but corresponding angles. So we got angle X angle as 130 degree. Therefore, we will get angle Z to be as 130 degree. Okay. So you can see the third question is given here. So here also we have to find out the unknown terms, that is X, Y and Z. We have to find out the value of X, Y and Z here. Okay. So just see, this is a type of rhombus. Okay. The rhombus figure is given here and they have given us here. They have shown us two diagonals which are bisecting each other. Okay. So in the rhombus, we know that when the diagonals are bisecting each other, they are making a 90 degree angle in the center. So all this four angles are nothing but the 90 degree each. Okay, so you can see one triangle here. So we will consider this triangle to be, we will add this triangles. Okay, so X angle X plus angle Y plus this angle is supposed to be taken as same, which will be equals to, we know that sum of all the three angles of the triangle is nothing but 180 degree. If we add all the three angles of this triangle, we are going to get nothing but 180 degree. Okay. So here X and Y, we don't know what are the values. Only 30 degree is given, which is equals to 180 degree. Okay. Now let us substitute X value as angle X value as 90 degree, because I already told you in the beginning, when the diagonals bisect each other, they are making an angle of 90 degree in case of the rhombus. Okay, so this is 90 degree plus angle Y we will keep as it is, plus 30 degree, which is equals to 180 degree. Okay, now 90 plus 30, we are going to get 120 degree plus angle Y, which is equals to 180 degree. So angle Y is equals to 180 degree minus 120 degree. Since we are bringing this to this side, it will become minus. So angle Y is nothing but equals to 60 degree. So we got angle Y is equals to 60 degree and angle X to be 90 degree. And now we need what is the value of this angle, that is angle Z. So here the angle Z will also be the 60 degree, which is equals to angle Z. Angle Z will be also equals to 60 degree, because this is nothing but the type of what this is nothing but, this is in this form, just see Z form, this is in this form. So this are nothing but, this both are nothing but the alternate angle. Okay, suppose like this. So this angle and this angle forms our alternate angle. So here also they have given it like this only. You can just see Z form. Okay, so this angle as well as this angle will become the alternate angle here. Okay, so both the angles will be equal. So angle X is nothing but 90 degree, angle Y is nothing but 60 degree, as well as angle Z is nothing but 60 degree. Okay. You can see the next question here. The fourth one is given again. This is a type of parallelogram. And here also they have given us to find out X value, Y value as well as the value of Z. Okay. Now you can see here one angle is given, that is 112 degree. Okay. So in the parallelogram, we know that the opposite angles will be equal. Okay. So directly we will write angle Y is equals to 112 degree. Okay. Since this are opposite angles are equal. Okay, then if you want, you can write the reason here. Since opposite angles are equal. Okay, next we can see, if we got here 112 degree, we need to find this angle, that is x angle. So we can see here one more triangle is formed. Okay, so we can take the angle here, angle x plus angle y plus 40 degree is equals to 180 degree, since the sum of all the three angles of the triangle is nothing but equals to 180 degree. Okay, so we don't know what is the value of x, let us keep it as it is. Plus we are having the angle y value, we got the value of angle y, that is nothing but 112 degree plus 40 degree, which is equals to 180 degree. Okay, next we got angle x is equals to, when we add these things, what we are going to get? So wait, let us write this. Okay, minus 112 plus 40 is nothing but 152 degree. So here we are getting 180 minus 152, we are getting nothing but 28 degree. Okay, so we got angle x is equals to 28 degree. So if angle x is equals to 28 degree, then we get angle z to be equals to 28 degree only. Why? Since this comes in a pattern of z manner, and here the inside angle as well as this inside angle. So this is in this form. So this inside angle as well as this inside angle forms an alternate angles. Okay, alternate angles, so both will be equal. Angle x is equals to 28 degree and angle z will be equals to 28 degree again. Okay, next moving to the last question here. You can see here they have given x, y, z. Again, we have to find the values of x, y and z. Okay, one angle is given here, that is 80 degree. So the angle which is opposite to this angle is nothing but y. So we can write directly angle y is equals to 80 degrees, since opposite angle is equal. Opposite angles are equal. Okay, so if this is 80 degree, this will also be 80 degree. Okay, now if this y is 80 degree, the z will also be equals to 80 degree. This is in this form, you can see. Okay, in the form of z itself. So this is our z value and this is our y value. If you turn this page like this, you are going to find out that you can see this value is a z value and this value is y value. So this is in the form of similar alternate angles. So again we can write angle z is equals to 80 degrees, since alternate angle to y. Okay, so we got y as well as z both equals to be 80 degree. Now you can see here, I told you this two adjacent angles will form an 180 degree. So x, angle x plus 80 degree, which is equals to 180 degree. So this is a linear pair. You can see in a single line, we will get both the angles. When we add both the angles, we have to get 180 degree. Okay, now let us move this 80 degree to this side. So we will get 180, angle x is equals to 180 degree minus 80 degree. So we got x value is equals to nothing but 100 degree. Okay, so I hope you are understanding this video. We will continue the next part into the next video. So please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.